This is Finished Work TV, a place of inspiration, wisdom, and revelation. As you listen and receive God's word today, your life will never remain the same.
Glory be to God. This is the day the Lord has made. Or rejoice and be glad. Welcome to Pray and Prophesy to Your Day. As we pray this morning, I want you to expect supernatural open door, preferential treatment, and supernatural increase. And hear the word of the Lord, great things are coming. It is going to be a season of more than enough for you to carry out the assignment on your life. Every instruction that God has given to you that will require financial resources, I want you to expect supernatural provision. I want you to expect supernatural help. I want you to expect supernatural increase, because in this season, God will be helping you to carry out His will for your life. As we pray and prophesy to today, I want you to have an expectation that mighty things are going to happen today. Great things are going to happen today. One of the basic reasons why we have to trust God is because trusting Him puts you in a position of increase. When we trust God, big things begin to happen. I like to look at the book of Joel chapter 2 this morning. The book of Joel chapter 2. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Librandos engrados ekanda. Bredos keteli gabarandos eketoli blagada. All things are possible when we trust God. Hallelujah. All things are possible when we trust God, when we believe His word, when we allow His word to come through us. I want you to expect uncommon help, uncommon visitation, uncommon release of the Holy Spirit. I'm looking at that scripture then in Joel chapter 2. I want to look at it from the NLT translation. Joel chapter 2 verse 21. In Joel 2:21, hear ye the word of the Lord, and look at what happened here in Joel 2:21 from the NLT translation. And it said this, thank you, Father. He said, don't be afraid. He said, don't be afraid, because fear can stop you from walking in supernatural possibilities. So he said, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, O land. Be glad now and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. He didn't say the Lord would do great things. He said the Lord has done great things. It is by faith I begin to walk in what the Lord has done. It is by faith I begin to see the manifestation of that which the Lord have done. He said, fear not. In Joel chapter 2 verse 21 from the NLT translation. He said, don't be afraid, O land. Be glad and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. And let me say this to you. For you to actually receive from God, you have to know that it is there. You have to know it is done. You have to know it is available. If I don't have the revelation that what I'm believing God for is available, my faith will not have basis for expectation. If I have no revelation that what I am looking for is available, if I don't have the revelation that what I'm asking for is available, then my faith have no basics to experience manifestation. And this is why it's important for you to know what the Lord have done. That is why it's called the finished work of Jesus. Jesus has finished it. He has done it. He has settled it. So it is by faith we'll receive it. So great things are coming. They are coming because it is time to put your faith to work. It is time to believe God for the things which He has told you. You can't give up on the promise of God because you had some disappointment, because you had some betrayal issue, because you have some issues of rejection, issues of frustration, emotional crisis. That shouldn't be a reason to give up on what God has sent to you. Because what God has sent to you have the ability to bring you to a place of greater possibility if you can believe it. So the scripture already has said, don't be afraid, O land. Don't be afraid. There is nothing to fear for. There is nothing to be afraid for. He said, don't be afraid, O land. Don't be afraid. Fear may try to come in, and maybe you're hearing some things right now. Maybe you had a doctor's report and maybe it's not in your favor. He said, don't be afraid. Maybe your banker just told you that you're in a very bad position financially. Don't be afraid. Maybe the business never came true according to your expectation. He said you should not be afraid. If God told you not to be afraid, that means he has a better plan, he has a better opportunity, and there are greater possibilities ahead of you. So he said, don't be afraid. So here he said, don't be afraid, O land, be glad now and rejoice, for the Lord has done great things. For the Lord has done great things. For the Lord has done great things. He didn't say the Lord will do great things. He didn't say the Lord is going to do great things. He didn't say the Lord will try to do great things. He said he has done it. So that simply means our spiritual accounts are already credited, and we're expected to walk in the revelation of that which is available to us. Now, I like to look at 1 Peter. Thank you, Holy Spirit. It's all in 2 Peter. In 2 Peter chapter 1, 2 Peter chapter 1, 2 Peter chapter 1, watch this. I like to read from verse 2. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 2, it said, may God give you more grace and peace as you grow in the knowledge of God and Jesus Christ. And look at what it said here in verse 3. It said, by his divine power, God has given us everything. He has given us everything that we need for living a godly life. Everything it takes to live the God life has been given to you. The day you got born again, your identity changed. The day you got born again, you expected to live from God's perspective and not from what happens around you. The day you got born again was the day you walked into liberty. And when you have the revelation of your liberty, you stay in your liberty. And great things are coming. That is a prophetic word this morning. In prayer and prophesy to you, the great things are coming. Expect great things. Expect good news. Expect things to work out for your good. Expect uncommon favor. Expect preferential treatment. Great things are coming. That should be the prophetic word for today. For this week, you begin to believe God. I see great things happening to me. I see great things happening around me, around my job, around my ministry, around my calling. Great things are here, and you're prophesying that, and you're declaring that, and you're believing that, and you're seeing that. Great things are coming. Let's begin to prophesy that this morning. We are walking in the season of great things. Great things are here in the name of Jesus. We prophesy manifestations of great things. See great things all over you. See great things around you. I hear the Lord saying, this is not a season of regret. There are people who are regretting about the bad decisions they made 5 years ago, 10 years ago, 15 years ago. They are regretting of those bad decisions they made. And I hear the word of the Lord saying, if they stop the regrets, they can open the door of faith for restoration. If they stop the regret, you know, because when people sit down and begin to regret and condemn themselves, it shuts down their faith, because faith works based on the knowledge of God's goodness. I said faith works based on the knowledge of God's goodness. So when someone is not seeing the revelation of the goodness of God, someone is not embracing that revelation, and maybe they are talking themselves down, condemning themselves, they're not making open door for faith. They're not opening door for faith. So we'll open the door for faith when we'll focus on the goodness of God. So I heard the Lord said, stop condemning yourself. Stop allowing guilt and condemnation to rob you the joy of releasing your faith to tap into the goodness of God. You shouldn't allow the situation. Yes, the mistake has been made, but God is not just a God of second chances. He's a God who will consistently stand by you to help you come into your destiny if you can believe in his goodness. And this is what the Spirit of God is saying right now. Stop telling yourself it's not possible. Stop telling yourself, I don't have the financial resources. I don't know who to connect with. I don't know where to go to. No, that's not what to believe. What to believe is the word of God. And when you believe God's word, you rise above limitation. You rise above opposition. You rise above frustration. It is in believing God's word, That you rise above frustration, that you rise above deception, that you rise above manipulation. So great things are coming. Conceive that prophetic word in your spirit. Conceive it. See it happening. Imagine yourself walking in those things the Lord spoke to you about. He gave you a word that you should go start this, you should go do this. But in the natural, you don't see the resources. Believe that the resources is coming. That is what faith is all about. Faith will take a step. Faith will take a step. If you're really walking by faith, you will take a step. You can't say you're walking by faith and you want to see the entire picture before you take a step. No, true faith in God will take a step when you don't see the entire picture, because faith is action based on God's word, not action based on the things you see in the natural realm. In the natural, you may not see anything that can tell you that God is going to make a way. In the natural, you may not see anything that will make you believe that God is going to work this out for you. You may not see anything, but when you start walking by faith, you begin to receive it. You begin to see manifestation of that which God has spoken to you. So great things are coming. Great things are coming. That is the word of the Lord for you this season. Great things are coming. Expect the manifestation of great things. Expect limitations to be broken. Expect disappointment to stop. Maybe you've been trying to get something for the past 5 years, past 10 years. Maybe God gave you a word that I'm going to do mighty things in your life. But in the natural, you don't see them. In the natural, you don't see those things. And you're asking this question, when is it going to happen? When am I going to finally walk in the harvest the Lord promised me? You have to keep applying His word. You have to keep standing on the word of God. You have to focus on those things that God has called you to do. You have to stay connected to His word, and you will have manifestation of His promise. We prophesy the manifestation of great things concerning our assignment, concerning our ministry, concerning our vision. We prophesy manifestation of greater things. Magunga Bradesa, Mendoza Ketoli Kadaba Sekababa. I hear the Lord saying, take the limit off your faith. Take the limit off your faith. Why are you putting that unbelief there? He said, take the limit off your faith. Take the limit off your faith. Take the limit off your faith. And how do you take the limit off your faith? It's when you start believing what God has said than the lies of the enemy. It's when you take the limit off your faith, when you start believing what God's word has said concerning you, and not the lies of the enemy. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Rambro se katalibla kanda baba. Rambro se katalibra tokorobo sanka baba. Rambra so kodobo sakala baba. Begin to see possibility. Maske to libla baba. Prophesy possibility. Prophesy possibility. Prophesy possibility. Concerning that assignment God gave to you. Concerning the word God gave to you. Prophesy possibility. This is not a time to go backward. This is not a time to say it's not possible. Prophesy possibility. Makuri gabarando. Me rambro se ketoli kandere. Rainbow Sakanda Baba, Rainbow Sakanda Baba, Santo Lobo Santa Baba, Melingro Sukutoliga Barando Sakitaliba Kanda Baba, Rainbow Sakitaliba Kanda Baba, Rando Seketalibla Karababa, Lingro Sekandaliga Barando Seketalibla, will prophesy possibility, will prophesy possibility, will prophesy possibility, will prophesy possibility. Mandoso Kandirika Barando Sekababa, Holy Spirit, have your way, Mazinde Rebo Sandalababa, Rainbow Seketolabra Tokodo Bracadalibro Tokorobro Sakadababa, Rambro Seketalibla Kababa, supernatural understanding is coming to you to make wise decision. And that's what the Spirit of God is saying. Supernatural understanding is coming to you to make wise decision. Supernatural understanding is coming to you. Makadi gadabusa, makadi gadabusa, makadi gadabusa, makadi gadabusa, makadi gadabusa. Supernatural understanding is coming to you to make right decision, to make wise decision, to make decision that can position you to do the impossible. Makuta elembrango gomazanga merosha kari gabrado seketolibla. Come about. Understanding is coming for you to understand what is going on. Understanding is coming for you to understand what is going on. Libro Sakamba. The spirit of understanding is coming upon you right now to for you to know, for you to move in the right direction, for you to make the wise decision. Makuriga parando, wandingando gumazanga diva sokamba. Understanding, receive understanding, receive understanding to be able to disconnect from anything with potential to distract you. Makaluba, receive understanding to judge the things happening around you. Receive supernatural understanding. Standing to judge the things happening around you. Kuka kotoma teka da kodo kamaba. Mele kandoro kumbari kandorambra kandarambra. Mandro tonton grabaton goda bradeske. Melingra ton seketo libla kambababa. Understanding is coming from the Holy Ghost. Manzu ketela bragada. You'll be able to do the things God has called you to do. I hear the Lord saying this. Don't allow your mistakes to distract you from trusting in my goodness. Don't allow your mistakes to distract you from trusting in my goodness. The knowledge of my goodness should exceed every mistake you have made in the past. Don't allow the mistake. You know, someone is just beating themselves and said, if I've done this right, this could have happened. If I've done this right, this could have happened. The enemy will always hold you bound in the realm of condemnation, and that is his major strategy. He wants you to believe that you're not qualified, you're not worthy, you cannot experience the best. He wants you to believe that you are responsible for your own salvation. No, you are not responsible for your salvation. Jesus is responsible for your salvation, and he has taken care of that, and he's expecting you to walk in your understanding of your salvation. So the voice of condemnation is the voice of destruction. So in the name of Jesus, will come against every spirit of condemnation, trying to put you down, trying to make you feel like you're not worthy, you're not qualified, trying to make you feel like life won't get better. In the name of Jesus, we'll bind every spirit of condemnation that leads to suicide. You know, the spirit of condemnation is what leads to suicide. Most times that people commit suicide or do suicide is because they feel they are not good enough. They feel that nobody's for them. They feel that God has forsaken them. They feel that they are alone. That spirit of condemnation and guilt frustrates people until they begin to commit suicide. They take their own life. And I bind that spirit in the name of Jesus. I speak wholeness to your mind. I speak peace to your mind. I speak liberty to your mind in the name of Jesus. Let this mind be in you that is in Christ Jesus. Look up to the word of God and not up to your limitation. The more you focus on his word, the stronger you become. Brosata, 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 kandere go sunkababa. Melingra toso kandare gabasu kapa. Pelekoto, pelekoto, pelekoto. Brakoto kandele kambaranko. Mandresa kanda mendo yomo sandayaba mundo yobo sandayaba mundo yobo sandayaba mundo yobo sandayaba sangara gada gada basa kanda baba. Or prophesy supernatural release. Or prophesy mighty things of the Holy Ghost. Will prophesy kretosa kalingra tosa come about. Head from above, hoso kadabra gadababa. There is an open heaven over you, and you're going to enjoy supernatural help. There is an open heaven over you, and you're going to enjoy supernatural help. There is an open heaven over you. Ideas from the Spirit. Ideas from the Spirit is coming to you. Supernatural ideas of what to do, how to do it by the Spirit of God is coming to you. Receive supernatural ideas of what to do by the Holy Ghost. My Sunday level Shakababa. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lamb of God. Thank you, El Shaddai. Thank you, Jehovah Jireh. Thank you, I am that I am. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the great things that are happening for us, for the great things happening around us. Thank you, sweet Holy Spirit. Lord, we thank you for prayer and prophesy to your day. If you're watching this broadcast and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, you can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart that God have raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. You pray that prayer with me, means you're born again. And the Spirit of God will lead you from this day forward. I want to encourage you to subscribe to my YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teachings on YouTube. When you subscribe, you'll be opportunity to watch live transmitted broadcasts that have potential to empower you to take the lead in the right direction. And also want to encourage you to watch us on finishworktv.com. We have videos on demand on that web TV site that you can watch and listen to God's word that can build you up and empower you to move forward in the name of Jesus. And I also want to encourage you to consider partnering with this ministry. You know, partnership is so strategic as we take the gospel to more people around the world. Partners are those that pray for this ministry consistently and then hear from the Lord whatever he will have them do to partner financially towards the broadcast of God's word to the nations. So if you want to do a financial partnership, you can just go to finishworktv.com/giving. And you can give from there. You can use your PayPal account and give from there. Or if you're on PayPal, we are faithmanteaching@gmail.com. On PayPal, you can go there and do your giving. We'll love you until our next broadcast. Don't forget this. There is greatness in you. And Jesus is coming soon.